Okay. Hello, shipmates. You might remember the last time we got together, we talked about the Battle of Midway and how our leadership, Nimitz and Halsey and Spruance, showed that they could take a calculated risk. They were bold, they were confident, and they were willing to be accountable. Well, go figure. Today, I'm here on the USS Nimitz, and you can see Admiral Nimitz over my right shoulder here today. So we're out here with RIMPAC, Rim of the Pacific exercise, operating with 22 nations, 40 ships, 6 submarines. We're here with our partners in the Pacific, our partners in South America, our partners in NATO, and yes, the Russians are here in this exercise. And I gotta tell you, it's amazing seeing all of our partnerships operating together. We're up in a helo today, and out there we can see our Australian brothers and sisters. We can see the Japanese ships operating with the Korean ships. It's very, very inspiring to see that. And it's most inspiring here today being on Nimitz and seeing your shipmates. And I look forward to getting out there and seeing every single one of you. But there's another thing going on here today. We're starting the operation of the Great Green Fleet. Now what that means is we're showing our concern and actually a potential solution to energy security, and that's biofuel. What we're gonna do today and for the next 2 days, we'll be operating Hornets, we'll be operating Helos, we'll be operating our gas turbines on our destroyers, and of course, we got the nuclear-powered Nimitz here, and we've got nuclear-powered submarines operating. So we have alternative fuels going on. Biofuel will be the key here that we'll be looking at. Now, biofuel is fuel made with algae, with plants, and with animal fat. And we'll be using a 50-50 mixture of that to show that, in fact, there's an alternative to petroleum products. Look, the price of fuel fluctuates, and you gotta understand that's a big deal to us. $1 change in a barrel of oil changes your bill and my bill, our fuel bill, $30 million. Just this week, the price of oil spiked $10, $300 million. So we've got to look for alternative fuels. We've got to look for alternative opportunities, and we've got to be efficient with energy. And that's where you come in, and that's where I come in. Let's be efficient with what we're doing out there, ashore and afloat. But in any case, celebrate RIMPAC, celebrate your heritage, and I look forward to seeing you out there. Thank you.